If you're a lover of all things outer space, get ready for some intergalactic news. This image has just been released by NASA, all the way from the James Webb telescope, and it shows what's been described as dust rings radiating around stars in distant space. So for some expert analysis, we're joined now by astrophysicist Dr. Jan Eldridge. Morning, Dr. Eldridge, who's going to talk to us exactly about what we're seeing here. Can you describe what you're seeing, what we are seeing in that picture?
Yeah, well, I mean, it's an image that you look at, and the first thing you say, like, that can't be true, that's got to be fake. That's just so regular and so almost beautiful, which is, you know, why we do astronomy, because while there's science there, it's beautiful. It's two stars that are orbiting around each other, very much like the Earth and the Moon do, but they're in an eccentric orbit, so sometimes they're further away from each other, and every 8 years, they come really close together. And when they get close together, the winds of one of these stars, which are very unlike our own sun, it's producing lots of carbon, that carbon gets thrown off, impacts with the material coming off the other star, and it gets squeezed, and it squeezes all that carbon into dust, something like cigarette smoke. And so then that gets thrown off out into the rest of these rings that we see.
That's incredible, because I was going to say, it's not usual, is it? Were you surprised when you saw these with this image?
When the team leader, Ryan Lau, sent it round to the team, I took time to actually realise, hang on, what am I looking at here? Because yes, stars don't make these regular patterns. We know of other stars producing dust regularly. But this is, I mean, we'd seen some of these before with the Hubble Space Telescope, but the JWST has been able to show that this is then producing all that dust in these rings. And this gives us an insight, because it's taken centuries for the stars to actually produce this dust, and for that dust to get thrown out to see it, because it's every 8 years it's making one of these rings. And so we can actually see into the history of this star as well. So it's remarkable. And it gives us an insight, because this is a new way that we know stars now making dust. And we know cool stars do, but this is a very hot star. And so it's like, it's an interesting piece of the puzzle to try and work out how everything's made in the universe.
So with this particular star that we're seeing in this image, do we know how far away it is?
Yeah, it's relatively close by. It's only 5,000 light years away, which is far enough away. But because we know how far away it is, when we look at these rings, we know that they're bigger than our solar system. If you were standing on the furthest ring, wow, one edge, and looking at the other one, it would take something like 2 months just for the light or your signal from a friend on the other end of the ring to actually talk to you, because it's that big.
It's incredible, Dr. Eldridge. I just wanted to ask as well, do we know, and forgive me if you've mentioned this, I was just fixing my earpiece, but do we know exactly what the dust rings are made of? What's inside them?
Yeah, so it's carbon-rich dust. So what's really exciting is that, you know, this is maybe one of the first ways that carbon-rich dust is made in the universe. And it's important because that dust goes into the galaxy around it, and it changes the way that galaxy sees, and we see this in galaxies across the time of the universe, but also it goes into making the dust that maybe goes into making future planets. So in a few million years, this dust rings may actually then come into some planet elsewhere within the galaxy. And so that's just part of understanding the life cycle of stars, that this one has to die to make the next generation of stars and planets.
Do we know if our sun has, I mean, you said these are two stars colliding, but our sun on its own, does it have anything like this at all?
It will produce dust, but only in about 4 or 5 billion years. So we've got a bit of a wait. But when stars tend to produce dust when they're just about to die, and so our sun will become a big cool star. And we know that plenty of those kind of stars like our sun make dust, but this is the first time we see one of these very hot stars make so much dust. And it's, again, trying to work out all these different sources is kind of exciting.
So it's exciting, but in a way that's kind of sad. You're saying that this is a star you know is about to die.
Sometime in the next, could be the next year, could be the next 100,000 years, this star will die. And I hope it goes sooner, because then we can understand, does that dust destroyed when the star explodes, or maybe will it survive? And that's one of the next big unknown mysteries. What's going to happen next to this dust? And I think hopefully it will survive.
That's incredible. Thanks so much for shedding light on that, Dr. Eldridge. I do want to ask you before you go, though, what's the thing about your job that you love the most?
There are just so many mysteries, because then you try and find a new mystery, and like this one, you find, oh, it's so exciting, and then you start thinking, well, this fits into a bigger puzzle, and you're trying to connect it to all your other knowledge. And I just like working out how things work, and there's no bigger problem than trying to work out how the universe and everything in it kind of works.
And I couldn't figure out if this is kind of like a virtual background, but is that really your office or is it a virtual background? Because it is super cool.
Yeah, it's the TARDIS in Doctor Who, so it's a virtual background. I'm
sorry. I thought it was familiar. I thought, oh, that's awesome. Dr. Jan Eldridge, we appreciate your time. Thanks so much for sharing your expertise on the show. Brilliant.
Thank you.